Of course, we've skipped the introductory chapter, the custom house. And I just want, yani one, perhaps one important information about this this chapter, because this chapter doesn't belong to the events of the novel themselves. But here, the writer tries to give us the germ of the story. يعني where does he get this story? So he works, Nathaniel Hawthorne himself works as an employer employed in the custom house. And he spent there many years, and one day he, yes? Okay, so in one room in the custom house, he found a pile of papers with a piece of, with a red piece of a cloth, a rugged, يعني old piece of cloth. وعليكم السلام. نعم. Anyway, yalla, let's go back to our subject. So, the importance of this chapter is to give you the germ of the novel itself, of the story. The germ, يعني the origin.
وصاير عشر
ها هيك مكتوبه بالاصل يعني بالعبري يعني احنا يعني ما يصير احنا ندرس الادب المسيحي خلينا نقول بدون ما يكون عندنا معرفه بالاساسيات بالاساسيات اللي احنا مو ما ندخل بالتفاصيل لكن اساسيات حتى من نقرا احنا نفتهم هذه الناس ليش هي تفكر بهالطريقه ليش تتصرف بهالطريقه
ليش ياخذون هذا العقاب مثلا
بالضبط لأنه أغلب الكتاب يعني وحتى الملحدين منهم لاحظوا حتى الملحدين اللي هم يقولون عنا ملحد ما يقدر يخرج عن ثقافة المسيحية ما يقدر يسلخ نفسه حتى لو كان ملحدا هسه هو كان ملحد عنده أتيتيود معين لكنه كثقافة المسيحية ثقافة الإسلام ثقافة البوذية ثقافة اليهودية ثقافة ما ممكن أنت تسلخ الإنسان وتطلع من هذه الثقافة 100% يجوز هو ما محتقد بواحد اثنين ثلاثة لكنه البقية هو محتقد به ما عنده مشكلة فهذني البقية هو يشتغل عليهم يبينهم أنه أوكي فخل يعني بس على مود أرجع لل من نقول the germ or the origin الجرم يعني جذر جذر الأشياء أصل الأشياء okay the germ of the story of the scarlet letter Hawthorne said that he found it in a room in the custom house he found a pile of papers with a rugged old piece of clothes, embroidered piece of clothes, red embroidered, red piece of clothes, an old piece, okay, an old cloth. When he read this, the story, طبعا it was written by his senior, أكو شخص قبله كان موجود هو المدير وهذه مكتوبة من خلاله. And he read the story and then as if he saw a vision.
Inspired him to write.
Yes, to inspire. He was inspired by the writer of these papers to, yes, to write the story of Esther Prime to make it public to the people. Okay? من باب شنو؟ من باب ال good example. من باب العبرة. حتى الناس يعني تعرف فيها وتعتبر. Okay? واضح هسه؟ يعني this is the major importance of this custom house. طبعا it has many details and the details مو يعني ما تهمني بقدر ما يهمني انه هذه الفكرة من وراء هذه القصة. ماشي واضحة؟
Okay.
Yes. For moral lesson. Moral lesson. Moral lesson يعني العبرة. Moral.
ممكن تعلم الدرس الأخلاقي الفكرة.
يعني هو درس أخلاقي. هو درس أخلاقي لكن اللغة العربية لغة جميلة. مو يعني مو redundant. هي من تقول عبرة شنو عبرة؟ درس أخلاقي. لكنه من نقول عبرة بها تنطيك يعني elevated style. فإحنا كون أيضا نرتقي بلغتنا. أقدر أقول أنا صف الأول أقولهم moral lesson بس الصف الثالث أقولهم لا عبرة. فالعبرة هسه هم يعرفوها تصير good example or moral lesson. ماشي؟ يعني هاي تفيدكم أيضا حتى في موضوع الترجمة. يعني اللغة العربية غنية بالمفردات. ما مو يعني ما بها كلمة واحدة وخلاص هاي انتهينا. So for this is for the moral lesson, and I told you yesterday that usually these writers they come to these solutions to make their novels realistic, more realistic than fictional. يعني they give the novel realistic details. واقعية. من نقول realistic يعني المسلك الواقعي. realistic يعني واقعي. أقرب إلى الحقيقي. أقرب إلى الهيستوريكال. لأن بعد كل شيء هذا النوفل يعني it is part a romance. Part a historical novel. It's a romance because basically it is a love story. Yes, a thwarted love story. يعني a destroyed love story. But the basic of the story is love. يعني the love between Hester and Dimmesdale. This love that turned into a sin. Turned into a sin. فهذا يعني it is part a romance. إذا جتكم إنه وط يعني إذا صح وخطأ مثلا وأقول لكم Scarlet Letter is considered by some critics as a romance. فأنتم المفروض تكتبوا لي صح.
هي فقط لا ترى مو كتير.
صح 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 مصطفى بس انتبه لي. إيه. Part romance صح. ليش؟ لأنه it's a love story. There is it is based on a love story between Hester and Dimmesdale. Yeah. But it is also historical. Why? Because it is based on real historical events. اللي هنا وين لقاهن؟ The pile of the papers. بالpile of the papers مكتوب تاريخ يعني تاريخ لأنه أكو تاريخيا أكو امرأة اسمها هستر وأكو رجل اسمه كذا أوكي فهي part historical part romance لكنه واقعا هي شنو هي fiction هي fiction فالكتاب يلجؤون لهذه الأساليب حتى ينطوها realistic touch لأن الناس تحب الحكايات الحقيقية اي لأنه it is related to them these people are similar to them يعني احنا ما نحب يعني نتابع الحكايات اللي تحدث يوميا بمجتمعنا،
حتى الافلام
بالافلام
based on a true story.
فاذا هذا انت لانه واقع يعني مو، فهم اللي يلجؤون الى هذه حتى ينطون realistic or realism to their novels اللي هي بالاصل شنو؟ فيكشن. فيكشن هي تروح تجي هي فيكشن. ممكن ياخذ الكاتب فكره بسيطه قصه هيك على الماشي، ياخذ ديتيل من عندها ويبني عليه روايه او قصه طويله او قصه قصيره او يعني اوكي. نعم، فهذا صار واضح هسه عندكم، ما عندنا به مشكله. نرجع الى شابتر 1 و ايش عندنا به؟ وين وصلنا؟ The prison door. احنا خلصنا تقريبا.
بس تقريبا تطلع
لحظة. احنا بس اللي هو chapter 1. We didn't describe the crowd. This is very important. A throng of bearded men. Bearded men. شوفوا دول الناس. الناس يعني they are bearded. كلهم ملتحين. يعني يعتبرون اللحية جزء من الدين. يعني جزء من الceremonies or the rituals. الritual. الritual يعني الطقس. ritual يعني الطقس مو الجو، من باب الطقوس الدينية. هذاك اتموسفير هذا ritual and rituality. rituals and rituality الطقوس الدينية. يعني ناس تلبس عمامة، ناس تلبس تطول لحيتها، ناس تشيل الشارب وتخلي اللحية، ناس تطول يسووا لهم اليهود يسووا لهم قصيبتين من نانة، وناس لا ناس الوهابية يقصرون. هاي يسمونها rituals. اي يعني يعني لكل ناس هم حسب يعني افكارهم الخاصه. فهذا الريتشوالز اللي هي محسوبه على الدين، بس هي من صنع الناس. يعني هي الناس عاجبها هذا اللي يطول قصايبه، وهذا اللي يزين شواربه، وهذا اللي يطول لحيته لين هسه ها هذا اللي يحط ديمقراطية. We are in a free country. Okay. In sad, شوفوا they are bearded. يعني حتى in order to give you the impression about these people, that these people are very, you know, tough and strict people. In sad colored garments. Sad colored. يعني they wear in black. They wear in black. يعني their clothes are black. They are bearded and they wear black colors. And the gray steeple crowned hats. The hats are gray. انت دا تشوفون عبالك uniform اكو. اي يعني gray والblack. Gray and black. Intermixed with women, some wearing hoods. يعني they cover their heads. The women, محجبات. ما يصير امرأة تمشي يعني حاصرة الرأس. أكو حجاب. حتى بس أقول لكم إنه شوفوا الحجاب غطاء الرأس موجود في كل المجتمعات. مو حكر على المسلمات يعني. واليهوديات لحد اليوم يعني إذا أكو بعض اليهوديات يطلعن يلبسن ربطة يشدنها لي ورا على روسي. نعم يعني يعني قصدك عند المسلمين الفيل، عند اليهود أيضا فيل يلبسون ما
ما
حضركم يوم متدينين
الحجاب كان بدون مو مستدل ليش تلبسه الدليل على انه هي مو تنباع يعني الرقيق فاللي ما تلبس حجاب كان اشاره انه هاي البنت تنباع تكون خدامه او ما شيء اللي كانت تلبس حجاب لا تكون بنت عائله فاللي الرقيق اللي كان ينهزم بالمناطق كان افضل وسيله انه مو تقتل افضل وسيله انه تعيش طبيعيه لكن تلبس حجاب حتى تضيع وياه على اساس هي بنت او شيء يعني الحجاب مو اصلا دين او شيء وانما الحجاب هو كان بيرمز هواي
هي حاجه اجتماعيه هذا اللي انا اريد اوصل لكم اياه حاجه basically it is social need then it was exploited by religion or sharia يعني in all يعني heavenly religions يعني مو فقط ترى حتى المسيحيه كانوا النساء يغطون رؤوسهم يعني باليهوديه ايضا النساء يغطون رؤوسهم حتى بالجاهليه كانوا النساء والرجال يغطون رؤوسهم بس الجاهلية كانت حاجة أكثر اجتماعية ليش؟ قولوا لي ليش يغطون رؤوسهم؟ ليش؟ لأنه عايشين بالصحراء فهذا الرمل ممكن يمزقها الوجوههم فيلبسون هذا على مود خمار يصير ويغطون بوجوههم زين ويكحلون عيونهم ايضا نفس الشيء كحلون الرجال والنساء ايضا الرجال يكحلون عيونهم حتى هذا الكحل يمنع الرمل ان يدخل للعين فايضا شوفوا هي مو فقط اصل الاشياء من تجدونها you will be relieved انه مثلا الكحل هو بعدين يلا صار زينه بينما هو بالبدايه ايش كان حاجة من صار الإنسان عنده لكجري قام يستخدمه كزينة ولا هو ما كان يعني ما كان زينة anyway so these people they wear in black they had gray hats and they are bearded so this shows that they are very very strict people the women somewhere wearing hoods and other bareheaded was assembled in front of a wooden edifice, the door of which was heavily timbered with oak and studded with iron spikes. The founders of a new colony, whatever, a utopia of a human virtue and happiness that might originally project have invariably recognized it among their earliest practical necessities to allot a portion of the virgin soil as a cemetery. So as they built a utopia, the good place, the sacred place, they built a cemetery, a graveyard. And another portion as the site of a prison. بالجانب المقابل they built a prison yes وين هذا راح in accordance with this rule it may safely be assumed that the forefathers of Poston so what is the setting we are in Poston The forefathers of Poston had built the first prison house somewhere in the vicinity of Cornhill almost as seasonably as they marked out the first burial ground on Isaac Johnson's lot and round about his grave. طبعا this is a rumor يعني هذا details حقيقية هي some of them are real يعني بس هذا الجريف مال ايزاك جونسون يعني رومر هو ما مدفون هنا which subsequently became the nucleus of all the congregated sepulchres in the old churchyard of King's Chapel certain it is that some 15 or 20 years after the settlement of the town the wooden jail was already marked with weather stains and other indications of age. يعني after 20 years of its built, when they built the prison, the prison withered. The prison was almost decayed. يعني عبالك بدأ القدم يبدو عليه. يعني 20 سنة بعمر البناء مو هواية. لكنه يعني it become to wither, it become decayed. هذا مهم لأنه حتى أشوفكم بعدين شنو معناه هذا. وينها؟ Yes. And other indications of age which have a yet darker aspect to its beetle browed and gloomy front. The rust on the ponderous iron work of its oaken door. Rust. صدأ. صار. على الحديد اللي مصنوع من عنده الباب السجن. Looked more antique. يعني مو مال 20 سنة. Older than this. Anything else in the new world. Like all that pertains to crime, it seemed never to have known a youthful era. Okay? So as if the prison, the author says that the prison have never witnessed youth. The prison is old. The prison is black. Okay? So here, the prison as being old is contrasted with what? With the young, with the youth of Hester Prynne. Hester is a youthful woman. And he wants to give us this, that the prison is old, just like these old people who are gathering here, by the way. يعني the crowd is full of old people. We can hardly find young person, young woman or a young man. So, yeah, in order at least to understand, to sympathize with Hester, because everybody here is old and they seem very tough, very fanatic, radical against the young people. Before this ugly edifice, and between it and the wheel track of the street was a grass plot, much overgrown with burdock, bigweed, apple barrel. These are يعني أحشاب وأنواع من الأحشاب. And such unsightly vegetation, which evidently found something congenial in the soil that had so early borne the black flower of civilized society. What is the black flower? The prison. He called it the black flower. Aku green vegetation. وبنص الجرين فيجيتيشن اكو بلاك فلاور. اوكي ذا بريزن اوف سيفيلايزد سوسايتي. اند يو كان سي هير ذا كونتراست بتوين ذا بلاك فلاور اند ذا سيفيلايزد سوسايتي.
يعني مجتمع متحضر بالسجن.
اوكي A prison, but on one side of the portal and rooted almost at the threshold was a wild rose bush. So the black flower is contrasted with the rose bush. The rose bush indicates beauty, love, hope, okay, forgiveness, peace, covered in this month of June with its delicate gems, which might be imagined to offer their fragrance and fragile beauty to the prisoner as he went in and to the condemned criminal as he came forth to his doom. يعني the prisoner who came in and the criminal who goes to be executed, for example, will pass and see this rose bush. They can see the beauty of the rose bush and they can smell the fragrance of this rose bush. So it's a kind of what? Of a mercy for them. It's a kind, it's a kind of gift for them. For those who get in and for those who get out. To the prison, okay. In token that the deep heart of nature could pity and be kind to them. So nature can pity them. Yeah, forgive them for their sins, but human beings cannot. This rose bush, by a strange chance, has been kept alive in history. راح ينطينا القصة مالتها وعن هاتشنسون وشرحنا عنها إحنا البارحة. يعني it is a rumor, it's a rumor that when the martyr Anne Hutchinson passed from this way, her footsteps, you know, implanted with this rose bush. يعني من مشت تدخل السجن حتى تقتل ها يعني خطوات أقدامها أنبتت هذه الروز بوش. Anne Hutchinson is a woman who was executed for her religious thoughts, for her religious ideas. Yeah, they call her blasphemer. And it's very easy to call anyone blasphemer and a witch at that time, especially. Yeah. نعم. يعني ما تقدر تصبر من لما تخلص محاضرة. يا يا بي شلون راح الصوم الشهر الجاي؟
اكو مجتمعنا ترى يعني واحد شوي عنده افكار تقدميه ممكن يقول لك
اخر. اوكي. Finding it so directly on the threshold of our narrative, which is now about to issue from that inauspicious portal, we could hardly do otherwise than pluck one of its flowers and present it to the reader. هسه هو ايش راح يسوي؟ راح he will pick up one of the flowers of this rose bush and presented it to you. Yes. What is this? Yeah, the story of Hester Brown. So it may serve, let us hope, to symbolize some sweet moral blossom that may be found along the track or relieve the darkening close of a tale of a human frailty and sorrow. So what is the Scarlet Letter? The Scarlet Letter is a story of a human frailty. Frailty means weakness. Frailty means weakness. الكلمات اللي أقول لكم عليها تكتبوها وتحفظوها لأنه راح أجيبها لكم أقول لكم هاي الكلمة اللي هيجي شتعني ما أنطيكم خيارات فأنتم تنطوني المعنى مالتها يعني أجيب لكم إياها بهالشكل أقول لكم the scarlet letter is a tale of a human frailty and sorrow. What is the meaning of the word frailty? أخلي لكم underline. شنو معناته؟ أي طبعا. You can explain it with many words or you can use one word. يعني it's up to you. واضح؟ So this story is about human weakness and about human sadness. So we are going to deal with one rose, and this rose is the story of Hester Prime. Now we have the marketplace. We can begin now the story of Hester Prime. We have the crowd, the scene is prepared, the stage is prepared. And everyone is waiting for the major actor to come in. Who is the major actor in this drama? Hester. Okay, Hester. What she looks like? Hester. Okay. She's young. What about her dress?
Her dress has something to do against this society she is about to live with.
Okay, يعني what simple words, what does she wear? شانت لابسة يعني.
Yes.
بريتش
She wears embroidered a cloth, a gown, a gown, an embroidered gown. Okay. Yes, golden with golden threads. Good. Hey. ضروري تنتبهون لهاي التفاصيل لان هو شوفوا المظهر مالتها هنا هي تشتغل كسيمبل يعني ذا سكارلت لتر هي الحقيقه سو شو مسويه يعني within her cloth she embroidered the scarlet letter the scarlet this red letter of A the A letter in red She embroidered يعني لأن هي خياطة فمطرزة مطرزة ال the letter A which stands for what? For adultery for adultery the letter A she embroidered it in red that is why it's a scarlet okay scarlet means red And she embroidered on her gown as part of her punishment. Okay? As part of her punishment. She looks youthful. She looks beautiful. She looks defiant. She was not defiant, يعني courageous. She was never afraid. She doesn't look afraid. Okay? She looks defiant. She looks daring or courageous, brave. Okay? What else? She comes holding a baby. Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Not to show the motherly emotion or affectionately.
Okay.
But to hide the letter A.
Yeah. So she embraces her child, hoping that she can hide the letter A. But this is ironic because what is the baby herself? The baby herself is the letter A. This is the problem with the women. رجال يسويها ويفلت. المرة ما بيها مجال. Okay? This is, in fact, it is not only the simple A, but the baby. Because without the baby, perhaps nobody knows about her adultery. Nobody knows about her sin. But because she was pregnant and her husband was away, so everyone knows that she's what? She has committed adultery. Okay? She has committed the sin of adultery. So she sits on the scaffold in front of the jury. أكو جوري يعني مجموعة من القضاة أو شيء يسمون محكمين أي يسمون محكمين وياهم الماجستريت and her baby's age is almost 3 months now and now because they spare her life because of her pregnancy and then for the baby and now it is the final decision whether to execute her to apply the punishment or to set her free. Yes, Muhammad.
Yes, doctor. Some of the prisoners people want to torture her by fire.
Yes, now we come. Okay, she was standing there and we have this kind of gossip among the crowd. And, you know, people were furious, angry at her and especially... Who's the very furious about her? No, women or men?
Women.
Women. Women were so merciless. Okay, women were so angry at her, and they wanted. Yeah, they wanted. Some of them wanted her to be executed. Some of them wanted to burn her in fire. You know, some doesn't, or some do not. You know, they want not to give her any kind of opportunity of even standing on the scaffold. Okay, so women were so tough, and their attitudes were so extreme against Hester Prynne. But this shows us the old women. The writer mentions one young woman who was more sympathetic. She's young, she's still young, and she is more sympathetic with Hester, which shows us that this young woman can understand Hester's situation. Yeah, that is why she tried to be sympathetic with her, unlike the older women who seemed very rigid, very stiff, and very tough in their judgment against her.
Yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
What will happen if Hester Prynne herself told the community that Dimmesdale committed adultery with her?
He will be punished. Yes, he will be punished. Okay, he will be punished. This is the story. Now we come to see that this is the sorrow, the suffering of sin. Yani, as you see here, Hawthorne was not interested in the sin itself, because he never shows us the sin. يعني when does it happen وشلون ما شوفنا احنا شوفنا رأسا the aftermath, the consequences of sin, and because he is concerned with the suffering of people who have committed their sin, like Hester. Hester suffered in public, and this is يعني this is good. In a certain point, you will see that this is good. She suffers in public for some time, and then she is relieved. يعني she had penitence. يعني توبه وخلاص. But unlike Dimmesdale, who kept himself tortured by his conscience. يعني لنا عذاب الضمير. عذاب الضمير يكون أقوى على الإنسان من ال public اللي هي يعني ال public punishment اللي هو العقاب الجماعي. يعني لا مو عقاب جماعي, يعني شو يسمونه, لا مو جماعية ماما, مو جماعية هي, وإحنا ما عندنا لا مقابر جماعية, مو عقوبة جماعية. أي يعني أمام الناس. إيه اللي هي popular, يعني in public. أنا بس أريد الكلمة يعني in public, يعني yes. إيه اللي هو شنو يعني بالعربي public, يعني أمام, يعني هو اللي أمام الناس. بس يعني هو باللغة العربية ما يقولون يعني أمام الناس, أكو فد كلمة علني, علن 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 عقوبة تصير علن. في العلن أمام يعني على. Okay, so this is you know, this is the situation. Hester was there, and she was spared her life. She was spared her life, but there يعني the eventual or the perpetual or the endless punishment is that she has to wear the scarlet letter all her life. Now, who interferes to eliminate, to lessen the punishment upon her? Yeah. Why? Because he was a priest. He was a very respectable and, in fact, highly respectable religious man. So he interferes with the jury and with the magistrates to eliminate, to lessen the punishment on Hester, to spare her life for the sake of the baby. ماشي؟ يس روح. زين بعد شو عندنا in the marketplace؟ This يعني the standing on the scaffold itself, this place of punishment is very important. يعني it is symbolic because we have it in this chapter, in chapter 2, and we will have it in more two places. يعني three, يعني the scaffold is used for three times. The last one is when Demoiselle stands on the scaffold, okay, to punish himself for his sin. So you have to pay attention to the scaffold as a symbol. يعني not only a symbol, but it has become a motif. This is called a motif. Motif. ليش؟ لأنه repeated. Repeated. Simple. لا motif. Motif يعني حافز دافع. هذا motif. زين. Repeated, simple. لما تنعاد الرمز أو تنعاد الصورة نسميه موتيف. فالسكافول أحد الموتيفز اللي موجودة بالرواية. إذن هسه ما دام يعني خلصنا تقريبا chapter 2 بقى عندنا يعني صورة مكررة أو رمز مكرر. صورة أو رمز مكرر نسميه موتيف بالإنجليزي. نعم. Yes. Yes. I don't think so, but it has become, you know, I don't know, in fact, I'm not sure about it, but it becomes like a kind of, you know, public punishment for the sinner. That it, because it gives the people, this A letter, will show the people that this person had committed the sin of adultery. By the way, يعني, the writer here said, يعني, he talks about what people expect. People, he said that people at that time could expect the person who stands on the scaffold to be a thief, okay? To be, sorry?
Ugly.
To be ugly, or to be an Indian, a red Indian person who is executed. يعني, they brought him to be executed. But they never expect a person to be executed for adultery, for sin. So it was very hard for them as a community to understand how this happens, and this sin, because basically they are very religious. They are very strict in their morality. And you can see, perhaps, they could forgive minor things, but not such a great sin. The sin of such a sin. So such a strict community will not accept it. So this letter becomes a severe punishment on the person because he has to endure, to stand, to bear the looks of people all his life, okay? Because she cannot throughout the novel, she removed it once, Hester. She removed it once in the forest, but she never she kept it يعني all her the rest of her life as a sign of her punishment, and she accepts it because she accepts her sin. She accepts her sin. She accepts the idea that she has committed a sin and that she has to stand the punishment for this sin. Now, the problem is that whether she internally she accepts her sin or not. يعني هنا هم طبعا الكاتب ينطينا هذا الجانب. يقول هو هذا صار public punishment. المجتمع هنا عاقب الشخص. لكن الشخص هو نفسه يا ترى مو عاقب. هو مقتنع انه اقترف هذه يعني هذه الجريمة لو لا. هنا المشكلة. هنا المشكلة. اي يعني اكو كونفليكت راح يصير عند الشخص. يس محمد اني يا ست هسه
يعني خايفه الصوت ما خلنا راح خلى
البرنامج. يس because of her act, and because she stood before the community, so she did not realize her sin. She was totally guilty. She feels guilty.
In fact, she tried to escape the crowd, Muhammad, by remembering her past. إذا انتبهت to هذا chapter, Hester begins to remember. To remember her past, her childhood, her family, her young days with her husband, the hunchback Chillingworth, who was older than her, and her days with him, and how they, يعني, he sent her to the New World on the hope that he will come back after her, and for many years he was lost. He didn't show. استخدمت yes yes when she was standing on the on the scaffold she remembered her past the flashback about you know about her childhood about her family so she you know she doesn't concentrate on the crowd at the time but in fact she runs away from the crowd by remembering her past happy days. Okay? Shukran. So she remembers her past happy days. إذن يعني إذن هي تحاول أنه تعوض عن هذا الوضع اللي هي به by remembering her past. Now, even this will give us this, يعني we will have this question. She doesn't care about the crowd. She was not frightened of them, or afraid, sorry, of them. And we will see. This is the problem, Muhammad. يعني this is the beauty of the story because يعني هي سهل إنه she regrets it. يعني أنت تتوقع الregret. لكنه اللي غير متوقع انه الانسان يعني here in this case she committed the action and she never felt sorry for it because she thought that it is her right it is her life and she can do whatever she wants with it and especially She never, يعني, after many years of her husband's absence, she thought that he died. Okay? And she had the right to live her own life. But then she is entrapped again into a very strict society that demanded from her to be that devoted, waiting forever wife. So, يعني هذا طبعا هذا يخلينا نفكر احنا هذا احنا هسه مو مع او ضد انه احنا يعني لكنه يخلينا نفكر انه does she have the right or she doesn't have the right does she have justification or not خلينا فقط يعني نفكر ونشغل العقل في هذا الامر ويجوز نتوصل إلى يعني إلى أنه to sympathize with her or to be against her. هذا يعني هذا بالنتيجة يصير.
استر إنه الفعل مالته أو
why in Arabic مرتضى try to talk in English.
Actually, Esther, we know that her sin.
Okay.
Her baby girl.
Okay.
Face more suffering and struggling in life, especially conflict inside her.
هسه إحنا بعدنا إحنا بعدنا بالبداية. أنا ما أريد أخذكم للأخير ويا بيرل نجيها. لكنه إحنا دا نتكلم جنرال عن الشخصية عن شخصية هستر and her يعني and her reaction and her reaction about her sin, whether she accepts it or she rejects it. She has to, she accepts the public punishment for her, but inside perhaps who knows what happens inside man. This is يعني this is what the writer wants to tell us. Perhaps some people will stand the punishment. Okay, يعني they accept it. لأن المجتمع يريد هذا فخلاص هم قابلين. But what about them? What about inside them? Sometimes, perhaps sometimes they will not be satisfied with this punishment. Yes. Okay. فthis is نرجع إلى ال ten commandments. أنا قريتهم بالإنجليزي لأن ما أعرف عربي. The commandments. لا شو سوي بالشرح؟ أنتم تعرفون يعني أنا ما أحتاج أنا راح بس أقرأهن لكم فأنتم تعرفون المعنى. زين؟ لا تعرفوهن اي احنا اي يعني انتم هذه تعرفوهن من تسمعون بالوصايا العشرة وبالخطايا السبعة كون انتم تعرفوهن شنو هن الخطايا السبعة وشنو هن الوصايا العشرة. طبعا الخطايا السبعة هن من ضمنهن هذني يعني من ضمن العشرة لكن العشرة يجي بها موضوع الإلهية موضوع التوحيد. I am the Lord your God. You shall have no other gods but me. موضوع الوحدانية. زين. You shall not make for yourself any idol. ما تخلي واحد إله في منزلة يعني تعبد شيء وها شنو معناته؟ مو تعبد بس صنم. لا مرات تعبد المال. مرات تعبد الشهوة مرات تعبد شخص يعني أنت يعني كلش تموت في سبيله. هذا مصطفى بس اسمح لي يعني مصطفى أتمنى يعني أي ماشي أكمل ونسوي الكومنتات أي يلا ماشي. أني أدل يعني معبود إنساني بشري آدمي كل ما يتعلق بالإنسان والمادة هو هنا يدخل ضمن الأدل. وطبعا حتى هذول اللات والعزة وهبل ومدري من هو هذول زين هذول كلهم أيضا أدلز. You shall not dishonor the name of the God, your God. To dishonor the name of God by bad deeds, by sins. Remember the Sabbath and keep it holy. السبت اللي هو اليوم الأحد بالمسيحية, يوم السبت باليهودية, يوم الجمعة عند المسلمين. And keep it holy, sacred. Sacred. هذا لك لعبادتك لنفسك. حتى تشوفون انه شوفوا هاي الاديان السماويه شلون مقتربه من بعضها البعض تختلف بالتفاصيل لكن بالاساسيات هي واحده. Keep it holy يعني keep it sacred. مو تروح تتعارض لو تقتل لك واحد بي ما يجوز.
انت على غير
مين؟ على honor your father and mother. You shall not commit murder. Okay? القتل. القتل حرام. احترام الأب والأم اللي هو احنا هذن عندنا موجودات بالقرآن وموجود بر الوالدين. لا تقتل النفس التي حرم الله قتلها إلا بالحق. Shall not commit murder. You shall not commit adultery. اللي هي يا هي زين. Okay. You shall not steal. You shall not be a false witness. شهادة الزور. You shall not covet anything which belongs to your neighbor. يعني لا تحسد الآخر، لا تحسد جيرانك. Okay. لا تحسد، لا تحسد. طبعا هي وأكو لا تشتهي زوجة أخيك. لا أكو واي يعني بعد لا لاات هذني. You shall not, you shall not, you shall not. زين. لأنه هذول أساس هذول الإنسان هذني يلتزم بيهن آني أضمن لا يروح للجنة. هذن يعني لا يعبد الله، لا يأذي الناس، زين، لا يحسد العالم، لا يعني. إذا تلاحظينه هواية متعلقة بالآخر بالآخرين. يعني الله ذكر نفسه مرة قال لهم عبدوني، والباقيات كلها معاملات، كلها معاملات احنا نسميها. يعني العبادات واحدة. هذا I am the Lord your God, you shall have no other gods but me. هاي عبادة، انه انتم بس انا عبدوني. البقية كلها معاملات، كلها معاملات. شلون تتعامل مع الناس؟ الباقي بزنس. صح، بزنس، لأن هي المعاملات بزنس. أنا اليوم من أنطيكم محاضرة بيني وبينكم بزنس، فكون أنطيها بأفضل صورة تستفيدون من عدها. ما أنطيها نص ونص معناتها المعاملة صارت مو صحيحة، وبالتالي أنا أعاقب عليها. نفس الشيء أنتم تقومون بالواجبات اللي عليكم تمشي الأمور، ما تقومون بها أعاقبكم عليها. ده شو هسانة مو الله، بس أنا أعاقبكم. أكو عقوبة، أكو بنالتي. لما أنت تسوي زين أني I rewarded you، من أتسوي مو زين أني أعاقبك. وهي معاملات، الحياة كلها تشوفوها عبارة عن معاملات. اللي يهمنا شوفوا السابعة You shall not commit adultery، اللي هي the heart of our novel. فأنتم شوفوا يعني شوفوا الناس وهذولا أصلا هم they are strict religiously and they can find an adulteress in front of them. What is their attitude towards her? And in their commandments adultery is forbidden. Adultery is a great sin.
أي.
بالضبط. فطبعا موقف الناس راح يكون موقف يعني كلش aggressive against.